In the ever-evolving world of 3D printing, there's a new competitor that's making waves not just for what it offers, but for how little it costs. Meet the Elegoo Centauri Carbon, a fully enclosed, feature-rich 3D printer that dares to challenge premium models like the Bambu Lab X1 Carbon at a fraction of the price. With a jaw-dropping price tag of just $350, the Centauri Carbon is nearly one-third the cost of the X1C, and yet it's packed with enough specs and capabilities to make even seasoned 3D printing enthusiasts sit up and take notice. But is it all just smoke and mirrors? Can a sub-$400 printer really deliver high-end results? Let's dive deep and find out. Design and build, a minimalist powerhouse. Right out of the box, the Centauri Carbon doesn't try to dazzle you with flashy designs. Instead, it offers a clean, compact, and practical look. It comes fully enclosed, which is essential when printing with temperature-sensitive materials like ABS or ASA. The enclosure not only keeps the heat stable but also reduces emissions and odors, thanks to the air filter and auxiliary fan, now relocated to the rear of the printer for better airflow and easier modding. The overall build volume sits at 256 by 256 by 256 millimeters, which should feel familiar to many users. It's a standard cube volume that allows decent-sized prints without hogging your entire workspace. The chamber also includes a 520 fan on the print head and a chamber camera, giving users a live feed of their prints, even if the camera's lighting might leave something to be desired. Hotend and heated bed, ready for engineering-grade materials. The Centauri Carbon is more than just a pretty face. It's equipped with a hardened steel nozzle, capable of heating up to 320 degrees Celsius, and a heated bed that reaches 110 degrees Celsius, making it compatible with a wide range of engineering-grade filaments. While this doesn't push it fully into the industrial zone, it lacks a fully heated chamber, it comes impressively close. In testing, the chamber was able to reach temperatures of around 50 degrees Celsius, which is more than sufficient for materials like ABS, ASA, and even TPU. Performance and speed. Surprisingly capable. One of the most talked about features of the Centauri Carbon is its speed. With large 60mm stepper motors on the X and Y axes, the machine boasts a maximum print speed of 500mm and 20,000mm and 20,000mm QWERTY acceleration. The hotend itself supports 32mm flow rate, which aligns with most high-speed printers in this range. Despite those numbers, users shouldn't expect to instantly reach Bambu Lab X1 Carbon level performance right out of the gate. While high-speed printing is possible, you'll need to tweak settings, especially with PLA. Overhangs can be a bit tricky at first, but with proper cooling and print profiles, the Centauri Carbon holds its own. The slicer software is simple and minimalist, but the real win here is that OrcaSlicer is fully supported. So, if you're already familiar with it, you're good to go. Sadly, Cura and Prusa Slicer remain unsupported, and Clipper Access is currently locked down despite Elegoo's history with it in earlier printers. Multicolor capabilities not quite there yet. If you're looking for a built-in AMS automatic material system like on the X1C, you're out of luck. For now, the Centauri Carbon doesn't support multicolor printing out of the box, even though the print head includes a cutter and a filament poop chute. The good news, Elegoo has officially confirmed that a multicolor unit is in development, with a planned release window in Q3 of this year. If they stick to the timeline, the Centauri Carbon may soon become an affordable multicolor beast, making it even more of a disruptor in this space. Bed adhesion and recovery. Almost perfect. Print bed performance is often a make-or-break feature. The Centauri Carbon shines in this department. The PEI build plate is double-sided, with one finely textured side and one rougher side. Adhesion is excellent during active prints, especially with ABS, and once it cools, the model pops off effortlessly. Power loss recovery is another plus. During a real-world blackout test, the machine resumed the print exactly where it left off, though in this case, the cooled print bed caused the print to detach mid-resume. So while recovery works, it's not foolproof unless the print bed maintains sufficient residual heat. Touchscreen interface. Functional, not fancy. The Centauri Carbon's touchscreen UI is intuitive but basic. You can access all core functions like leveling, filament loading, Z-offset calibration, and input shaping from here. There's no eye candy UI here, just straightforward controls. But for a printer in this price range, it more than does the job. A minor annoyance is that filament loading and unloading can be glitchy. Sometimes the buttons become unresponsive unless you manually heat the nozzle first or restart the printer. Not a deal breaker, but worth noting. Leveling, Z offset, and mesh. Smooth and reliable. Leveling is semi-automated with a built-in sensor. While the mesh bed data isn't visible through the UI, the auto Z offset works beautifully with PLA and requires only minor tweaks for other filaments. The leveling process can sometimes feel sluggish due to multiple probing passes, occasionally 6 or 7 per point. It's a small-time cost for extra accuracy, and most users probably won't mind the slight delay. Print quality, stellar across materials. Let's talk results. Brute LA. Once you tweak the overhang settings, the Centauri Carbon delivers sharp, smooth, and consistent prints in PLA. Minor adjustments to fan speed and print profile resolve the initial imperfections. ABS and ASA. These filaments printed beautifully. There were no warping or adhesion issues, and the enclosure's temperature retention worked perfectly. The chamber doesn't get hot enough to be considered heated, but it's warm enough to avoid splitting or curling on mid-sized ABS prints. TPU. Flexible filament printed smoothly and cleanly with little stringing. While not as refined as printers with direct drive extruders built specifically for flexibles, the Centauri Carbon holds up surprisingly well. PPS CF10, the ultimate test. To push the Centauri Carbon to its limits, a test was run with Polymaker Fiberon PPS CF10, a carbon fiber reinforced filament that's notoriously difficult to print. It's typically used in industrial-grade machines with heated chambers and high-temp nozzles. The Centauri Carbon succeeded, but with one caveat. The PTFE tubing's sharp angle made feeding the brittle filament nearly impossible. The workaround was to bypass the PTFE altogether. Despite this challenge, the resulting print was strong, detailed, and dimensionally accurate. Then noise and chamber lighting, room for improvement. Two of the more noticeable shortcomings are the chamber light and fan noise. The chamber light is dim to the point of being almost useless. You'll find yourself opening the door constantly to check progress or needing external lighting for time-lapse recordings. When the auxiliary fan is turned up to full blast, especially to handle overhangs, it can get pretty loud. Not unbearable, but definitely not whisper quiet. Upgradability and mods. Open to possibility. Elegoo seems to have left the door open for tinkerers. The auxiliary fan's rear placement frees up room in the chamber, potentially enough space to add a bento box air filter, or even experiment with a heated chamber mod, though the built-in motors may not tolerate very high ambient temps. Firmware, compatibility, and slicer limitations. The printer currently does not support clipper or give terminal access. This is a bit of a letdown, especially for power users hoping to run custom scripts. There's also no integration with popular slicers like OrcaSlicer or Cura, though OrcaSlicer works great out of the box. Elegoo may roll out firmware updates in the future to add compatibility, but for now this limits customizability. And that's a wrap on our deep dive into the Elegoo Centauri Carbon. If you've been looking for a budget-friendly alternative to high-end 3D printers like the X1 Carbon without sacrificing too much in features or print quality, this might just be the perfect match. Sure, it's got a few quirks, but at this price, it's seriously hard to beat. Let me know in the comments, what do you think of the Centauri Carbon? Is it worth it for the price? Are you excited about the upcoming multicolor unit?